And let's go to the next question, which is something that we don't talk too much about, or I haven't seen too much videos about. And the question is, what is MIDI? What is the MIDI Out plugin? I've recently used this plugin several ways and in several different projects. And this is a plugin that it's not really well understood. And because of this plugin, I will show you a way for you to add extra sounds into your library of sounds for free. And it's very, very easy. So let's see what is this plugin all about. So to access this plugin, you just go to your browser or to your channel rack. And there's an option here called MIDI, and this is the dashboard and the MIDI out. So let's call this MIDI out. And as you can see, if I start playing notes, I'm playing notes with my keyboard, nothing happens. Nothing really happens in this one because there's no sound associated with this plugin. This just sends information. So if I send here, if I start adding notes, let's say that I add notes like this, for instance, if I play this, you see that this is playing, but nothing is, no audio is going out. And this is a very important distinction that we have to understand. It's like MIDI is just information. It's not audio. It's just information. And we can send this information outside of FL Studio. So let's say that you have a virtual keyboard or a keyboard connected to your computer. If it's one of these MIDI keyboards like I have here, as you can see, I have this MIDI keyboard there. It's from M-Audio. Today, I'm using one from Arturia. And this is a MIDI keyboard that you just simply plug in into FL Studio. And this is a plug and play. So you plug in through USB and you can just send notes into FL Studio. Those notes that are sent from these keyboards into FL Studio are MIDI information. It's MIDI notes. And MIDI is a protocol to share audio information or musical information between devices. And for instance, you also have, if you have a sound card, you will probably have a MIDI interface. I did a video with my TD3 from Behringer, and this video was how to send data from FL Studio to that, to the TD3. And one of the things, or one of the ways I used to do that was with MIDI out. And if we jump into FL Studio again, you can see that we have here this port selector. And if you go to your options and MIDI settings, you will have what is called the, or you will have your devices here. And as you can see, I have my Arturia KeyLab 61 and is enabled, but there's no port associated with it. There's this MIDI in Arturia KeyLab 2, and this is connected to port 1. And then I also have my Focusrite USB MIDI, and this is, again, there's no port selection here. There's also some outputs, and the outputs is what we are interested in. So this inputs is when you connect a keyboard into your computer or to your computer, you plug it in, and you can start sending information to FL Studio, and that's these input devices. So as you can see, if I click my keyboard, you see that I have note on and note off. And I'm clicking now on C, note on, note off, note on, note off. But if I were to come here and disable this, I'm clicking again on the same key and nothing happens. You see there's no information there. Now I have to enable this and now I get information back again. So this is the stuff that is coming into FL Studio. MIDI out just is the same thing, but going out of FL Studio. So let's say that you have a keyboard connected to FL Studio and that keyboard plays some sounds. It's not a MIDI keyboard. You can connect a MIDI cable into that keyboard and control that keyboard using FL Studio. You can do that with a MIDI with a keyboard, with a piano. You could do that with a synthesizer like the TV3 that I showed in the video. So there's several devices, external devices that you can be controlled with FL Studio. And you do that with this MIDI Out plugin. And as you can see here, I have my Focusrite USB MIDI in, and there's no port selection here. So let's say that I wanted to send from my audio interface, I wanted to send MIDI information on port 2. As you can see, now it's synced. I would go here and put on port 2. And if I were to send notes from this MIDI out, if I were to play this now with these notes here, this MIDI information is going outside through my Focusrite interface, as you can see here in port 2. If I were to remove this one here, then this information will not, this information will not be sent through my Focusrite. And that's basically this MIDI out plugin. This MIDI out plugin do not have any audio. It does not generate anything. It just sends MIDI information outside to the outside world from FL Studio. So you are working here, let's say that you have a bunch of synths that you want to control, or pianos or whatever. You just connect some MIDI cables from your audio interface and to the synth that you want to control, or the device that you want to control. Then you have to configure the MIDI settings here of your Focusrite output device. And then you have to use the same port here. And by using that port, you will be able to send MIDI information from within FL Studio and control the notes that are being played in your synth. And then you can record that audio back into FL Studio. I know it could be, it can be a little bit hard to understand all of this stuff here, but it's after you do it one or twice, you will get the basic idea. But again, this is just some testing. You have to go ahead and do some testing with yourself. If you have a MIDI device or a synth that connects, that accepts MIDI, that would be enough. If you just use a MIDI keyboard, you don't have to do that, because it's a USB MIDI keyboard most likely, and you just plug and play, and it's very, very easy to work with.